Hey there, this is Tracy, and welcome to our challenge. This is the week that to me is the most important because it's the mindset week. True transformation begins in your mind. I can tell you what to eat. I can tell you how to move your body, how to exercise, how to drink your water. I can tell you everything. But if your mindset isn't in the right place, you will not have success. So I am a health coach and a mom of three boys. Yes, there are two in college, one in high school, and an entrepreneur. And I love being home with my kids, helping them. And now with my empty nest coming out, my goal is to help you. Help people create a healthy body. And where does that healthy body? It begins in your mind. And I'm so excited to share this information with you today. It's one of my favorite topics. So my goal is to inspire you to live your best life, increase your energy, eat clean, healthy, good for you food, and to get fit. So to check on you from last week, all right, some of you have already started and some of you might be brand new, and that's all okay. So how is your food going? You know, be honest with yourself, be introspective always, and ask yourself, you know, how did you really do? Hopefully you're logging everything in on MyFitnessPal so that you can really pay attention to if you're eating enough. You remember you need to get at least 1,200 calories in a day. Are you moving your body enough at least six times a week? I would really, you know, 7 day, yeah, you can take a break. But walking, you know, you can walk every day. And are you drinking enough water? Are you getting in your good gallon a day? And most importantly, are you writing in your journal? Now, if you've already started that journal process, if you already started my mindset homework, then maybe, just maybe, this is a review for you. But you know, sometimes you have to hear things more than once to make it really sink in. And I love this graphic from Motivation Into Habit. It says, working out doesn't have to be a chore. Have fun with it. And that has to go with your food too. I can't stand it when somebody acts like this is a sacrifice. This is not a sacrifice. This program is about creating a healthy body. It is about putting food inside of your body that either hurts you or helps you, right? Everything you eat is going to be a benefit or it's going to not be a benefit. It's going to hurt you. So this is all about just creating healthy cells, creating strong muscles, hydrating your body, and being healthy. So now here's the scary stuff. Obesity has now been said, it was declared a disease recently, okay? That's crazy. Obesity is now a disease, just like heart disease and cancer, okay? It's right there. So it also is a precursor to disease. Now, obesity leads to heart disease because you're putting all that extra pressure and workload on your heart. It leads to stroke, type 2 diabetes, and several cancers. It is the second leading cause of preventable death. And obesity, the medical cost was $147 billion in 2008. That is crazy. This is something that I am here to help you change. And where does it start? In your mind. So whether you think you can or think you can't, you are right. That's not my quote. Sorry, I didn't write down who wrote that one. More scary statistics. Okay, so most of you are all adults over the age of 18. I think all of you are. So other scary statistics is our children today are more doomed than we are. Okay, more than a third of U.S. adults are obese. That's 33%. Approximately 17% of children are obese, and that's tripled since 1980. One out of seven low-income preschool children is obese. We're talking preschool. That's 3 and 4 years old. And in California, look at that map right there. Over 20% of children are obese in the low-income categories. And I'm sorry, but I blame things like McDonald's on that for giving you, you know, cheap garbage. It's just ridiculous that they feed people that stuff because they lure them in with the price and then they just give them garbage. So on the CDC, the Center for Disease Control, they have this great map. They have that shows you how the rate of obesity has climbed in the U.S. And you can actually watch like a really cool PowerPoint, which maybe I'll actually add that into one of our slideshows just to show you what's happening. And we need to change. We need to bind together as a community and change this. So next, I want you to think deeply and look into your future. Now, if things keep going the way they have been going, do you like what you see? If not, then we need to talk. We need to work together and make a change. Now, one of my favorite quotes is, "Nothing happens until the pain of staying the same becomes greater than the pain of change." Everybody says it's so hard to change, it's so hard to change. And you know what it is? Okay, I'm gonna agree. We all get stuck. We all get stuck in our comfort zone. But when the true transformation is going to happen is when it hurts to be stuck where you're at. So what's your story? How did you get to where you are today? We all have our story, and that story is personal to all of us. We are nothing but a compilation of one small step at a time, one act at a time, one thought, one action. We are just a compilation of all these little things that have happened to us and things that we've done with it. Well, what I'm going to ask you to do is journal down and write out your story. And now, what do you want? Look into the future a year from now, and what do you really, really want? Now it's time to dream. You can create anything in a year from now. So you look into the future a whole complete year from now, and you can make whatever you want, make changes whatever you want them to be. I love this poster. Okay, this is hanging in my workout room, and this is this older woman in her swimsuit looking sharp, and she's like, "Growing old is not for sissies." Now that's the way I want to grow old. I want to be just like her, looking sharp in my swimsuit and just being cool. So now the answer is why. I also have this poster. I don't know if they're together or a couple or whatever, but I love it because look at that old guy. I mean, he looks great. Okay, so why do you want to transform? Do you want to grow old in good health like these two? Okay, do you want more energy? Do you want to look better? Do you want to feel better? Do you want to be alive for your children, see your grandchildren? Do you want to be able to move without pain? Why do you want to transform? These are all important things, okay? So it's what do you want, and then why do you want it? The why is your anchor. It's what's going to help you when you feel discouraged, when you get tripped up and you want to throw in the towel and you say, "Forget it, I'm just going to go back to McDonald's or go eat this whole thing of ice cream." That's not what we want, right? That's not going to help you. Somebody said to me recently, which I absolutely loved, "Do you think you're going to get fit by going to the gym one time?" No. And exactly the same that you're not going to get fat by blowing it on one meal. So just because you mess up or you go to a party and you have something you shouldn't have had or whatever, that's not going to make a difference. Just get right back on track in your next meal, your next 3 hours, okay? But why do you want to transform? That is your anchor, and that's what you need to focus on, your vision and your why. So now it's time to design your best life. What you're going to do is journal whatever you desire, okay? So write your vision in present tense of if it's already happening. So it's a year from now, say it's Labor Day weekend 2015, and I'm out at a barbecue, swimming in the pool, I'm looking great, feeling proud of myself, you know, whatever your life you want it to look like. It doesn't just have to be about your health and your body. It could be about your career. It could be about your relationships. It could be about your home. It could be about your hobbies or anything, your service. What do you want your life to look like? And we are going to do a self-care seminar soon, and that seminar is going to help you piece together all of those different written goals. Now, one thing I want you to do when you're thinking about it is download this song, Unwritten by Natasha Bedingfield.
Oh,
sit down with your journal, play that song over and over and over, okay? That song inspires me. It makes me cry. It makes me smile. It makes me so happy because you know what, you guys? We can do whatever we want. It's just about dreaming big and then making that first step. So we're not going to fight the whole battle at once, right? We need to do it step by step. So choose one or two things this week that you can focus on, things that you know you should do. That's one of my journals right there, you guys. I love to write. I love to put my thoughts on paper. That's why I'm going to write my book. No freaking way. W-E-I-G-H. Yeah, I'm working on it. So choose those one or two things that you're going to focus on this week and write them in your journal. And just focus on those small changes and then they will happen. For instance, I used to love Diet Coke, okay? And that's like the one thing I just had such a hard time giving up. And then you know what? One day I just decided, why am I putting this poison in my mouth? I mean, I can't remember how long it's been. It's been a while, but still, it was just one thing. And then next time when that's easy, then you're going to just do one more thing, okay? So the other thing I want you to do is write your why on note cards and post them around your house. Post one on your refrigerator and in your pantry. So when you are getting stressed and you want to use food for something other than what it's intended to cope with those emotions or to help you with your boredom or because you're stressed, you look at your why. Okay, and your why, maybe there's a picture of your kids. I don't know what it is, but focus on that and realize you're not giving up on me. You're not giving up on Chris Powell. You are giving up on your dreams and your why. The other thing is read your affirmations daily. For instance, make a list of whatever affirmations make you feel good, like they're already happening. I am beautiful. I am strong. I eat only healthy foods. I exercise daily and I absolutely love it. All right, that wraps up your mindset workshop. We will get on our phone call to answer questions on Monday at 5:30 Pacific. Hopefully you have that number. I'll post it below the video. Please also post your questions on the Facebook page, The High Energy Girl. That's my page. So hope you guys are doing well. See you next week. Have a happy weekend and talk to you soon.